got a son. You've got a son. We've all got a song to sing.
Howdy, this is the Fresh Tune Show. My name is Dave Paltz. And today's Fresh Tune Show is the third show of my series, Writing Your Song. And it's called Singing with Others, but Writing Alone. And I'm going to start today's show out sharing the second song that I wrote. I think it was inspired by Bob Dylan's Blowing in the Wind, because the title is called The Wind. And I was 18 years old, and I was trying to figure out things and slowly evolve from that religious background that I had been brought up in and try to discover more of who I wanted to be and what rang true and what I had been taught and what didn't. This is the second song that I ever wrote, and this one is called The Wind. And that song was called The Wind, the second song I ever wrote. Still feel pretty good about that song. I was just starting to learn how to write songs, and I had been inspired by James Taylor. And even though I'm going to play some songs later where I joined other folks and it helped me to grow, certainly as a musician and a songwriter, right now I'm going to play the song that I played many times of James Taylor. And even though this recording is 50 years old, if you can imagine what recording sounded like in 1970 when we listened to something recorded in 1920 or whatever, it sounded, boy, that sound quality wasn't that good. This was recorded on a cassette, I think, and then cleaned up. But I think I was able to express some things that maybe I haven't expressed in other songs since then. You've Got a Friend.
When you're down in trouble and you need some love and care, and nothing, no nothing is going right, close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you have to do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. You've got a friend. If the sky above you grows dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind begins to blow, keep your head together and call my name out loud, and soon you'll hear me knocking at your door. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you have to do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. Now ain't it good to know that you've got a friend, when people can be so cold, they'll hurt you, yes desert you, they'll take your soul if you let them. Ah, oh, but don't you let them. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you have to do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. You've got a friend, you've got a friend, you've got a friend.
Well, there were other inspirations for my songwriting, and one of the groups that was an acoustic group, which was kind of unusual. Then I think most popular music was more electric instruments in the 1970s, late 60s. This group, the Crosby, Stills, and Nash, was a big inspiration to me and my friends sitting down and playing together. And this was a time when we just flipped on the recorder and recorded this song called Teach Your Children.
Have a cold.
goodbye. So please become yourself, because the past is just a goodbye. And teach your children well, their father's hell will slowly go by. Ones you picked, the ones you know by. And don't you ever ask them why, if I told you you would cry. Look at them and sigh, and know they love you. Fears that your parents grew by. So please help them with your youth. They seek the truth before they can die. Teach your parents well, their children's hell will slowly go by. And feed your dreams, the ones you picked, the ones you know by. Don't you ever ask them why, if I told you you would cry. Look at them and sigh, and know they love you.
This is the Fresh Tune Show, and today's theme is called Writing Your Song, Singing with Others, but Writing Alone. So I've been sharing some songs recorded in the early 1970s of myself and friends, and it was kind of the beginning of where I was starting to write more and more songs. Certainly played a lot of Dylan songs. I don't know how much I learned to write songs from playing them, but I'm sure I learned something from playing those songs so many times. This is a song I played with a friend, Terry Dell, who's a very good guitarist, played some really sweet leads. Once they started to play out, we played this song a number of times. It's called Simple Twist of Fate.
Was then he felt alone.
wish that he'd gone straight and watched out for a simple twist of fate. They walked along by the old canal, a little confused I remember well. Stopped into a strange hotel with the neons burning bright. He felt the heat of the night hit him like a freight train, moving with a simple twist of fate. A saxophone someplace far off played as she was walking by the arcade, lightly through a beat up shade where he was waking up. She dropped a coin into the cup of a blind man at the gate and forgot about a simple twist of fate. He woke up, the room was bare, oh, he didn't see her anywhere. He didn't care, opened the window open wide, felt an emptiness inside, to which he could not relate, brought on by a simple twist of fate.
And I don't know why my mother, who's quite elderly at the time, would come out and she'd love that song. It's about a sailor who hooked up with a prostitute. I don't think she got the gist of what the song was about, but she loved the song, and I think it's a pretty sweet song, and Terry certainly did a great job on the lead. This next song, I had another friend, Dave O'Lear, playing some bass with it, and it was one of those times we flipped on the recorder and recorded another one of James Taylor's song called Fire and Rain.
Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they laid put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. sunny days that I thought would never end. Seem lonely times when I could not find a friend. I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. You just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. And I won't make it any other way. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. Seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. I've been walking my mind to ease the times. My back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Hours and hours on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines and pieces on the ground. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. Seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you one more time again. Thought I'd see you one more time again. Thought I'd see you, thought I'd see you one more time again.
Well, James Taylor was certainly an inspiration to me and made me want to write songs of my own. Today's show, I started out sharing the second song that I ever wrote, and that was called The Wind. The next song that I wrote shortly after that is called When. And these early songs I played for very few other people. I wrote many, many songs before I started to play them for my friends. In the next episode of Writing Your Songs, I'm going to talk about how to begin inviting other folks to play your music and seeking out folks that are really into the songs you're singing about, because they really need to be invested to put their best sides into the music that they're adding to your songs. But I'll go into that more next month. This song was one that I wrote totally off by myself. I don't know if I ever shared it with too many folks. Be honest with you, I just would write these songs and store them away. The more songs you write, the better, so it doesn't hurt to write as many songs as you can and just store them in a cardboard box, and maybe someday you'll come back to them, or they'll come back to you years later and be even clearer than when you first wrote that song. This song is simply called When.
I don't know.
Well, I hope through these writing your song shows that I've been doing that I encourage young songwriters. They might be old in age, but they may be young and getting started to write songs. Sometimes playing some of the crude early stuff, I hope, gives a sense to those young songwriters that it's a process, and most importantly, that you're sincere and you are getting at the core of who you are and what you want to say and what you want to contribute to our society. And if we do that, then things will work out and we'll probably become better songwriters, and most importantly, we'll enjoy it while we're doing it. That's the last song that I'm going to play for today. I'm going to leave today's show with the encouraging words that you can do it. Sometimes you might wonder, why am I doing it? But if you can get into the moment when you're writing the song or singing the song and floating off into this world that is really cool, then I think you'll keep doing it, and I think we'll all benefit from it. So have a great week. Write your songs, paint your paintings, or write your poems, or do whatever creative thing you enjoy doing. And if you're not doing something right now, think back to when you were younger and some things that you really enjoyed doing, and pick up that pen or that paintbrush and play around with it again. You know, you don't have to paint a masterpiece. The masterpiece will be for you and will be a great creation and be a big plus for your own growth. Thanks for tuning in now. So long.
Who you are, who you are, who you are, the sun.